DNA fingerprinting technique. Today we are going to see what is the connection between a DNA and your fingerprint. You can see here DNA and fingerprint, and both are unique to each person. It won't be similar for anybody else. So that's why we call it as we are comparing uniqueness between the DNA of a person and the fingerprinting of the person. What is the reason? It's nothing but due to genes, isn't it? Okay, now we'll see first about who discovered this DNA fingerprinting technique. DNA fingerprinting, who discovered this first? The DNA fingerprinting technique, it was first, it's also called as DNA profiling. It was used to identify the similarities of the DNA fragments of two different persons. It was first discovered in 1985 by Alec Jeffrey, the great man called Alec Jeffrey. DNA of an organism, it carries some non-coding sequence. So non-coding sequence are also called as introns, we have studied, and some repetitive sequences. They are called as mini satellites or VNTR or variable number tandem repeats. So in the number of repeats, it's specific from person to person. This is the basic behind this DNA fingerprinting technique. So all the DNA of a person, it consists of non-coding sequence or the introns, and the repetitive sequence called mini satellites, and VNTR or variable number tandem repeats. How many times the number of repeats occur, based on this we can distinguish a person's DNA from one person to another, by Alec Jeffrey in 1985. So it was developed by Alec Jeffrey in 1985, and same chemical composition of the DNA we have, but there are millions of base pair, difference in the DNA sequence of the base pair, that gives difference to all the person's DNA. But the uniqueness among us is what? Except the identical twins, it's different from each other genetically. All the other persons, they won't have same DNA, different DNA and fingerprint. They are different from person to person. So we call it as DNA of a person, and fingerprints, they are unique. Unique means orutharodhu innortharukku irukkar. Completely different from person to person. That's why we call it as, it is unique. Okay. Now, how many human chromosomes we are having? 23 pairs. How many genes? More or less 1.5 million pairs of genes. Their arrangement, number, it will vary. So, genome sequence will vary. The genes are the segments of DNA which differ in the sequence of their nucleotides. Some DNA sequence, already I said, they are having non-coding sequence called intervening sequences. They are called as introns, and some repetitive DNA sequence. One more I said, what is the basic for VNTR in DNA fingerprinting? Short repetitive nucleotide sequence, they are specific for a person, and such nucleotide sequence are also called as variable number tandem repeats. We'll see this in a picture next. VNTR na enama, variable number tandem repeats. And what is the number of base pairs of genes in human chromosome? 1.5 million pairs of genes. Okay. So, introns, repeated DNA sequences, and VNTRs, these are based on this only. We are going to analyze the DNA fingerprinting or DNA profiling technique. So, VNTRs of two persons are, show variation. Let's say we can use this as genetic markers. Now, you can see the different bars. You can see barcoding technique. DNA fingerprinting, it involves identifying the difference in some specific regions in DNA sequence, that is called repetitive DNA, because some of the DNA, it is repeated again in the same way, means you can see the difference here, and some of them, they are repeated, and such DNA are called as repetitive DNA. In these sequence, a small stretch of DNA is repeated many times. So particular DNA fragments repeated again and again, so it's called as repetitive DNA. These repetitive DNA are separated from total bulk genomic DNA by means of different peak. You can see the different peak here. During, we are doing this in density gradient centrifuge, already we have seen. So density gradient centrifugation technique, we can see the repetitive DNA is separated from bulk genomic DNA. So we can find out the bulk DNA forms a major peak, but the other small peaks are referred to as satellite DNA. Bulk ingrathu motta DNA. Adala particular small peaks are referred to as Saturday DNA. Okay, yeah. So based on the base nitrogen-based composition, adenine, thymine-rich region, guanine, cytogen-rich region, the length of the segment and number of repeated units and satellite DNA and microsatellite and mini-satellite like this, it will differ. So these sequence do not code for any proteins. We are not representing any proteins. It's not referred here. But they form a portion of human genome. These sequence, they show high degree of variation, that's called as polymorphism. That is the basis for DNA fingerprinting. So we'll see here a number of persons, paternal chromosome, maternal chromosome, the DNA from individual A and individual B is given here. Here, this is the DNA collected from a crime scene, criminal portion, it was collected. Now we are taking this amplified repeats by gel electrophoresis technique. So this is the DNA sequence, it's taken from the criminal, and there are criminal from the collected spot, okay, where the crime was taken and take place. And this is the two suspected persons DNA sequence. Now we are comparing the DNA sequence analyzed from the taken from the crime spot. It is compared to these two suspect persons, we can find out the person B is having the similarities with the criminal person. He can suspect and we can find out by means of DNA sequence, we can find out the analysis, isn't it? So like this, you can see the differences in different peaks in the tandem sequence of different persons. And this is very important. You can find out what are the similarities. Get this one and this one. Or resembling this one and resembling. Like this, comparing the DNA sequence which is collected from the person from the criminal scene compared to the suspected persons, and we can find out criminal na C. And this is completely resemble like that of the person B, like this. Okay, now we'll see the next one. The DNA is how it's isolated from the blood, hair, skin, any part of the person which is collected from the crime spot, it can be collected and give the genetic evidences about the DNA. It is compared to the, this is called VNTR, variable number tandem repeat patterns, okay, by means of centrifugation density gradient with the DNA of the criminal suspect. Okay, this is the DNA of the criminal suspect, and this is the innocent person and he is a culprit. Like this we can compare. And we can find out the criminal by using this technique. Right? VNTR patterns are useful in establishing identifying of a homicide victim, either from DNA as a evidence to from the body itself. So we are collecting the blood, hair, skin cells and other genetic evidences. And this is the collected persons. It's resembling the DNA collected from the crime scene. Can see these two are completely resembling. Here the C is the criminal scene, the individual which is collected, the blood cells or DNA is collected from the crime spot, and A and B are the two persons. We are comparing with the DNA collected from the criminal spot, and these two are completely resembling. So who is the culprit? The B. He is a murderer. Like this we can find out. So this is very useful in criminology. We can use